Daniel H. here. We have worked on an extension of the fuzzy contour theory toward the more general class of dynamical systems, which are systems that are nonlinear, time varying, whose equations are unknown. This work, we give an online learning method to develop a state space fuzzy controller from a data stream. The objective is to control unknown nonlinear time varying systems. We want that a model, a fuzzy model, is developed from scratch autonomously. We emphasize procedures within the learning algorithm for data coverage and to have memory from the past to achieve Lyapunov stability of the closed loop system. Our method is called SSF-bean. In an application example, we consider it as the Hannon map, a nonlinear chaotic system. We start with a difference equation, F and an algebraic equation H, which are in general nonlinear, time varying. The system is discrete. This is a function of the states, contour inputs, and the time. We consider the system observable and that the outputs are the states. And then, well, H could be any other nonlinear and time-varying function. For example, linear combination of the states, but you consider, as you consider that this equation can be removed, we work with the difference equation. So we don't know the difference equation, so we want to develop a fuzzy model F prime, model of F, and from F prime, we want a controller G that will inject control signals in the original dynamic system and lead the states to wherever you want. So this is called the regularization problem. We want to stabilize a fixed point of the dynamical system X star. As the time goes by, the system states should converge to this X star. Schematically, this is what I have just said. We have an unknown nonlinear time varying system F. A data stream comes from the system. An online learning algorithm develops the fuzzy model SSF bean model F prime. We solve linear matrix inequalities. The solution of these LMIs will give a controller G to inject counter inputs in the original dynamical system F. F is the Hannon map, which is this. It is a chaotic system. The states never repeats exactly. This is the phase plane. This is how the states evolve over time. There's no control here. So the counter input in this case is zero. Our fuzzy model developed from scratch has rules of this type. The antecedent terms of the rule are trapezoidal membership functions, which form fuzzy hyperboxes in the phase plane. The output, the consequent of the rule, contains a linear state space model. Everything here is variable over time. The amount of rules, the membership functions M, the system matrix AI, but the B matrix, the actuation matrix, without loss of generality is common for our rules, which means basically that the counter input is applied to the first state, but the other states are also controlled because of these covariance elements of the system matrix. The output of the fuzzy model is this, a fuzzy combination of the local contributions. Our algorithm running, we granulate the phase plane. These green hyperboxes are fuzzy. There are state space models within the hyperboxes. They evolve. This is the evolution of the fuzzy rules This is the convergence of the error over time and the estimation of the states. Now with F prime in hands, we use parallel distributed compensation to obtain a controller, a fuzzy controller. The antecedent terms of the fuzzy controller are the same of that of the fuzzy model. We have trapezoidal membership functions in the domain of the states. The consequent term of the control rule is a control law, which depends on this matrices K, which should be redesigned whenever the model changes. So the controller is also evolving. We have time-varying membership functions, time-varying rule bases, and system matrices, and game matrices K. The output of the fuzzy controller is a fuzzy combination of the local control signals. And when we put the model and the controller in the same loop, the evolution of the states is given by this equation, which depends on the system matrix, the actuation matrices, and the gain matrices. So the evolution of the system is in our hands by means of the gain matrix. We should give a method to obtain K, and K is obtained by this equation. It depends on Kiel and P, which are obtained from the solution of these LMIs. The first LMI comes from a fuzzy Lyapunov function, a quadratic function of the states. If this matrix P is positive definite, the function V, the Lyapunov function, is positive definite and its derivative is negative definite, which means that the states will be the system will lose energy as the time passes. The energy will be dissipated from the system and we will achieve convergence of the states. For that to happen, this LMI must be true. It means that we have to solve a linear programming problem and find a solution for P and Q to make this true. And if this is true, we have the Lyapunov stability of the closed loop. The same for equations 2 and 3. If these LMIs hold true, we guarantee that stability using bounded control inputs. The controller will be given by this. The controller is running here. We have information granules for the antecedent part of the control rules. When we turn the controller on at iteration 200 until 300, and then again at 500 until 600, you see the convergence of the states, the input that is applied. Take a look at this point. The system gets out of orbit and comes to the origin. This is what we want. Notice here that how the black dot gets confined in the granule that was drawn close to the origin. We evaluate the results using the root mean square error and the energy that is dissipated from the closed loop system and the settling time, which means the convergence of the states to the point in a 2% margin around the point we wanted to converge. For different hyperparameters, we may achieve different granular maps, here with 60 fuzzy rules, here with 10 fuzzy rules. For a more compact rule base, we pay a price in terms of the root mean square error. You notice that the red dots in the inner and outer curves are a bit distant from the true values, the black dots. In this case here, it's quite close. It is a good approximation, even with a compact fuzzy rule base, but we pay a price for compactness. This is the trade-off. It is important to have a compact rule basis because the LMI design problem depends on that. The number of rows and columns of the LMIs are much smaller when we have compact rule basis. So it is a subjective decision which hyperparameter for the granularity of the model we should choose. It depends on the design of the controller. An example of the convergence of the states when the controller is turned on, when the controller is turned off, the system gets back to its orbit. The control signals that are applied to the actuator to make it happen. The best hyperparameters we get, is 0.3 for the granularity, an intermediate value in an upper bound of 1.5, which means we let the control input works in a higher margin to achieve the best results in terms of the settling time and the dissipated energy. This figure illustrates how the states spiral toward the origin, and it gets close to the origin to spiral again until the infinity. The controller is on here. We introduced a state space evolving fuzzy modeling method and a way to design a controller on the fly. Information grams and rule based are adaptive. We deal with the most general class of dynamical systems, nonlinear and time varying systems whose equations are unknown, guaranteed Lyapunov stability of the closed loop using bounded inputs. An application example on the regularization of the Hannon calls has shown the effectiveness of the approach. In the future, we will address trajectory tracking beyond regularization, and some potential applications are in artifact suppression, physiological signals, secure communication, fault tolerance systems.